We have just one more. So our question number seven asks us what are graph quadrants. So let's draw out a graph. So if we're given, well, we know, I guess I should say instead, that a graph consists of y in on this vertical axis here and x on the horizontal axis, right? So we know that the top of this vertical axis is the positive y and the bottom is the negative y. And we also know that the right side of the horizontal axis is plus x and the left-hand side of that is minus x. So that leaves four quadrants. We have one quadrant, two quadrants, three quadrants, four quadrants, right? And quadrant just essentially means the, well, quad is four, so when we split the graph into four parts, we have four quadrants. So here we have quadrant one, here we have quadrant two, here we have quadrant three, and here we have quadrant four. These are in Roman numerals, so just know that. And that's how they're usually labeled. And as you notice, I counted them in a counterclockwise way, okay? So from these quadrants, you know that everything within this quadrant here has a positive x value and a positive y value because of where it's located. It's only on the positive side of the x-axis, and it's only on the positive side of the y-axis. So positive x and positive y in the first quadrant. Now in the second quadrant, we have the positive y, but the negative x. We have negative x and positive y in this second quadrant. In our third quadrant, we have the negative x side of the axes, and we also have the negative y components. And finally, in our fourth quadrant, we have positive x and negative y. Okay, so let's look through the solution because there's also an example we can go through. So in the Cartesian plane, it's a two-dimensional graph that contains all negatives and positive values of x and y. So based on these values, we can divide the Cartesian plane into four different sections called quadrants, and they are bounded by the x and y axis, or axes. The first quadrant, let's leave that showing. First quadrant is located in the upper right corner, and we have the, let me just circle them as we go. So we have our first quadrant, we have both positive x and y. Second quadrant here, we have negative x and positive y. We follow along here. The third quadrant is located in the lower left corner, we saw, and that's a section where both x and y are negative. And lastly, our fourth quadrant, we have the positive x and negative y. So we notice that we label these in a counterclockwise manner. So starting from our quadrant one, where we have positive x and positive y. And then we also notice it says here that when quadrants are diagonal from each other, they are similar, as in we both have the same signs. So this one has two of the same signs here. This has two of the same signs, and then we, for these across from each other, we have one negative and one positive, one negative, same thing. Okay, so this one says here that we're going to try a sample problem. So if we need to graph the points 5, 4, so we have 5, 4, well, that's an x value, that's y value, remember? So we have in the house, that's how I remember it. I always remember x is in the house and y is up the stairs. So that can help you with order. So positive 5 and Plus four. Now I don't have labels, obviously. You can see I don't have labels on my graph, but this would show the general manner I'm finding our 5-4 point. Let's just do one other. So we also have here given minus 4 and 2. So let's try to find that. Well, minus 4 is our x value. So that means in the house, minus 4. And then we have upstairs, or maybe if that was a negative, downstairs. But anyways, a 2. So going up 2 because it's positive 2. And we will get something like this. Sorry, you can't see, but I'll show you what it looks like in a second. But that's how you would use the quadrants. So here we go. So I just did the 5-4 points. We have negative 4 and 2. And then finding negative 1-3, well, we go in the house negative 1 and down negative 3. These axes aren't labeled, but it's the same where this one is y and this horizontal one is x. And then we also have 5 and 3. So that's in 5 and down, or sorry, 5 and 7. And down 7 since it's negative 7. All right, current solution. And we are cutting close on time. That's all for today. And let's go back to this. So that's all we're going to be covering today. If you did find this helpful, please leave a like and subscribe so that you can be notified of when we do another Q&A. Also hit the notification bell. If you want to submit any of your own questions, you can see the links in the description below, like I said before, and try to submit them there. So thank you for watching.